For us, it's a dream come true. And it was an act of love. I think you can't look at that board and not see all the love that's in there. It's beautiful because the art is beautiful. And we were hoping, and you always do, you sit and you worry because you need to know how people are going to respond to it. And so when we saw the audience response and so many people have been crying, we knew that what we intended, we had achieved, and that is to honor the artists, to provide something that is useful, that's functional, that teaches our children about the past and the present, and gives them a way to think about their future, and also gives everyone something to be very proud of.
I want to thank you. Yeah, I want to tell you how much it makes me so happy to see you here joining us. This is really a special moment in all our lives because it truly empowers us. This is First Voice, driven by us, each and every community leader, artist, that has shared with us their information, their resources, believing in this. But I have to tell you that this is one of the most remarkable things I've ever worked on, because I've always thought about making sure that we have our fair share, that we're at the forefront. And I get tired of knocking on those doors, you know, like, let us in, represent us, we should be there, on and on. But we said, hell with it. We're gonna do our own thing, where people get to see 180 artists, 7 communities, learn what these vibrant communities have to offer, where to eat, where to visit, cultural centers that have dedicated their lives to make sure that our people have access to the arts. And I did this with a remarkable woman, Dr. Pamela Quiroz, who never stops dreaming. It's scary sometimes. But I'm in it. When she first told me about her idea, I'm going, what does that mean? And then she started talking to me about what she had seen. Influence as a young person, because she's always loved art. Seeing the technology, the science of industry, the juxtaposition between technology and knowledge. And she said, maybe we can do this here. And I thought, you mean we could put the arts together? You mean that artists can see themselves in one place? You mean that our students, our schools, our libraries can once and for all see the wide breadth of art, where the seed of creativity takes place in our communities? That they can actually see everything that you do and give back to the community? That visitors can say, I'd love to buy that piece of artwork. Let's take a QR code so that I can go and communicate with that artist. Or I want to see that mural. Or I want to learn about that history. All in this digital board. So, without any delay, I'd like to introduce to you a work in progress, the Latino Cartographies Immersive Walls. Showtime.
Radio Morales.
Caballero y público radio escucha.
This is a historical event. This is an event that I've been waiting for the past 35 years. And before, the community was not a tight-knit web. And today we have at least the promise and the hope that it will be for the future. And seeing that the amazing percentage of Latino here in Houston is just, you know, the moment, and we were just waiting for it.
When I saw all the presentation, I almost cried. I was just filled with emotions, looking and recognize so many artist friends there, and then recognize my art within that presentation. I feel really proud to belong to the Latino community and to be a part of this wonderful project.
Como artista, no tenemos palabras, y hablo en general, para agradecer este gran proyecto que finalmente lo vemos terminado, o ya en un proceso donde podemos disfrutar los detalles de tanto trabajo durante 3 años, ¿no? que han estado haciendo este proyecto.
Getting a whole bunch of like research assistants from U of H to create this with us, it just made it all of our own. This is all of us. This is us in Houston. This is us. This is the artists. This is the everything we represent. Even earlier, I was hearing a whole bunch of artists say that they recognize so many things, and even someone that's lived in Houston for so long. I had a university member come up to me saying, I'm not from Houston, but I've lived here for all my life, and I recognize everything on there. It truly becomes something that everyone recognizes because it's us, it's Houston.
Es una gran alegría esta oportunidad de estar representados y de tener esta ventana de proyección. Me parece un trabajo fantástico, extraordinario. Se nota que he hecho con un inmenso amor.